Hello everyone, Max here with Fiction Rant to bring you an actual rant. Star Trek Discovery is not getting renewed for another season after this one, so now's my opportunity to air my gripes about the series. In short, Star Trek Discovery is non-canonical heresy to me, and I stopped watching partway through season 1 because I couldn't take it anymore. So here's my top 5 reasons to stop watching STD, and yes, I am going to continue calling it that, and then forget ever existed. Reason number 1, retcons. Immediately in the pilot, it retcons how the Klingons get a hold of cloaking technology. In the original series, despite several encounters with Klingons, none used a cloaking device until Kor, commanding the Klothos, used one to successfully attack the Federation outpost at Caleb 4. Suddenly, in STD, there's this ancient Klingon vessel that gets dug up by the Klingon prophet T'Kuvma, which has apparently had a cloaking device for ages, but it's the only ship at the outset of the war using such a device for some reason, because apparently Klingons are stupid, and a huge technological advantage like that was just reserved for antique vessels with a bunch of coffins stuck to its hull. Even if the Federation figured out a way to penetrate cloaks, having one would still be better than not, because the Federation ships would actually need to be looking for the things in order for that to matter. So I don't buy the excuse that they just stopped using it because eventually people would figure out how to work around it. That would be like a sniper throwing away his ghillie suit because it can be countered by using infrared imaging. Basically, this retcon means that Klingons are stupid, either for forgetting about the tech or just not using it because it wasn't quite good enough. And then not bothering to fix the design for a decade for some reason, and then just starting to use it again arbitrarily, and that's a really crummy thing to do to your longest-running alien faction. Reason number 2, art direction. I know that modern Trek likes to make everything look all shiny and such, but right away in STD, the Klingons are redesigned to be these hideous purple creatures with caricature levels of exaggerated features and clothing that obviously impedes their movement, as opposed to, you know, battle armor. In the transition from the original series, with its shoestring budget and all, it was understandable to have aliens amounted to human but with intense eyebrows, or human but more blue. In TNG, the races got differentiated a bit more by giving Klingons really intense forehead ridges, wild hair and body armor, and after that, the design remained pretty much the same. That is, until STD came out and invented a whole new alien for the Federation to fight and told everyone that these new and improved Klingons are better, and you'd better like it. Who cares that the previous designs were carefully and lovingly crafted by whole teams of makeup artists and producers? This is better, I promise. Then, on top of that, they took the sleek and elegant ship designs of the Klingons, which were always kind of predatory and dangerous looking, and replaced them with ships that kind of look they were grown. The problem is, I actually love these ship designs and wish they made more. They're just not Klingon. Create a whole new race of aliens and give them these ships and let the Klingons have their old stuff. Reason number 3, Michael Burnham. Ah, the main character. We've had the rogue Captain Kirk, the gentleman diplomat Captain Picard, the battle tactician Captain Sisko, the far-from-home resourceful Captain Janeway, and the visionary Captain Archer. So what do we get for STD? A war criminal, responsible for literally millions of deaths because of starting a war. Michael Burnham! Yay! Oh, but she cries in most episodes, despite having a Vulcan upbringing alongside Spock, because remember Spock? Remember how awesome Spock is? Well, Michael Burnham is way more awesomer than Spock and is basically Space Jesus later on, so she can mess up in the biggest possible ways, but it's okay, because she's awesome and we need her or something. We all deserved better. Reason number 4, Tilly! This is more of a personal gripe, but it seems like every Trek series feels compelled to insert a character who's just annoying. These characters are generally given redemptive arcs where people look past those annoying tendencies to see something brilliant underneath, but that's not always the case. In TNG, it was Wesley Crusher, who fortunately got sidelined pretty hard later in the series when he went to Starfleet Academy. In Voyager, it was Neelix, who was not only annoying, but also a stereotypical jealous boyfriend to his 2-year-old girlfriend Kes, because that's not weird at all. He eventually got over the jealousy thing, but he stayed annoying for the rest of the series. DS9 actually did this the right way, by acknowledging that Rom was an annoying idiot, and then just rolling with it before revealing the well-earned revelation that he's actually kind of brilliant in engineering and is generally just a super wholesome guy, but he's super socially awkward. The perfect redemptive fan insert character for Star Trek fans. Then there's Tilly. I haven't watched most of STD, as I mentioned earlier, so I don't know if they eventually fixed her character, but at least early on, she's basically a toddler they paired up with Burnham to annoy her. And annoy her she does, and the rest of us. I know what they were trying to do, this odd couple, you know, pair the woman who was raised by Vulcans and thinks too much with her head rather than her heart with somebody who only thinks with their heart, which would be fine, except that Burnham is one of the most disastrously irrational characters in the series already, so pairing her up with a hyperkinetic version of that just doubled down on awful. Plus, is it too much to ask that the war criminal responsible for millions of deaths and the start of a huge war by committing treason and getting her captain killed actually suffer a bit for these actions? And I mean on screen, not via flash forward and mopey face expression. Number 5, finally, the Spore Drive. Remember, this show takes place before and kinda during the original series, and there's this drive that requires torturing a creature from another dimension or torturing a genetically modified crewman so the drive doesn't just kill everyone aboard your ship, which in exchange gives you the ability to instantly teleport your whole ship anywhere with basically no cooldown. Isn't that amazing? That's way better than warp drive, transwarp drive, and even possibly transwarp beaming, depending on what you're wanting to do. It's maybe a bit unethical, but hey, this is war, and then everyone forgot it existed. Discovery gets caught up in some time or dimension shenanigans and disappears or whatever, and with it goes all the knowledge of the most powerful form of faster-than-light travel anywhere ever. This is dumb. First of all, this assumes that the Federation is stupid and kept not only all relevant information about the Spore Drive project on the pair of prototype ships it built, along with every scientist and engineer who ever worked on the concept, and apparently the entire shipyard that built the stupid things. Secondly, it assumes that no other faction in the entire galaxy could come up with anything similar, or that they had some ethical compunctions against using it. Both of these have to be true, or the drive makes no sense existing in a prequel series. The especially annoying part is the second part. I could believe that Starfleet abandoned the tech because it's unethical to use, strategic advantages be damned, but the Romulans, the Borg, the Klingons, the Cardassians? Does anyone think that they'd have a ton of hangups about poking a giant tardigrade creature to gain ultimate mobility? Okay, the Klingons might, but they're kind of inconsistent with the whole honor thing. Every other faction we see has a bunch of things in common with the Federation. Everyone has shields, everyone has warp drive, everyone has phasers or some kind of equivalent, everyone has artificial gravity, and this could be during first contact. We've never seen these aliens before, and they have all of these things. But STD is trying to claim that only the Federation could come up with Spore Drive. I don't buy it. The worst part is, I think the Spore Drive is actually a really neat concept which Star Trek could absolutely use, just not in a prequel. Have it be something that was developed after Voyager got home and told everyone about fluidic space, prompting the exploration of other dimensions or something. Maybe encounter an entire alien race of Myconid people who use Spore Drive instead of Warp Drive. Wouldn't that be neat? Basically, do anything except what you did. And there's my top 5. Again, I stopped watching STD partway through season 1 because it just annoyed me so much, but it's entirely possible that Tilly becomes this wonderful and beloved character and that they fix the Klingons, but I honestly just don't care. They lost me at hello. And to me, STD does not exist, so I'm just going to rewatch DS9 or something, and until next time, live long and prosper, and may the Force be with you.